The Philippine National Police Public Information Chief Red Maranan is now the acting director of the Quezon City Police District. He takes over from Brigadier General Nicolas Torre, who resigned after hosting a highly criticized press conference for Wilfredo Gonzalez, a former cop who pulled a gun on a cyclist during a recent traffic argument. PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo replaces Maranan as acting PIO chief. The chief of Rodriguez Police in Rizal relieved from his post to give way to an impartial probe into the killing of a 15-year-old boy. On August 24, Police Corporal Arnulfo Sabillo mistakenly fired at teenager John Francis Ompad, which was initially intended for his brother, who was being chased by authorities for allegedly failing to stop at a checkpoint. A probe into the case is now underway.
May pag-ano rin kami doon, yung lalong-lalo na doon sa sinabi na yung homicide lang ang kaso. Dahil mababaw lang na ano yun. May pinatay naman siya na bata na hindi naman talaga dapat niya gawin yun. Yun ang inaano namin na sana mailagay sa murder ang kaso. Manawagan din ako sa mga matataas ng opisyal ng mga kawani ng mga kapulisan natin na sana mag-ano nila yung mga tao nila na hindi gumagawa ng ganun na kaagad na baril kaagad ang ano, barilin mo na kaagad ang tao. Hindi dapat ganun. Sasalain sana nila yung mga tao nila. Well, sana ito huli na ang ano ito.
Ompad is the second teen killed by the police in August alone. Navotas cops also killed 17-year-old Gerald Jemboy Baltazar in a case of mistaken identity. The Philippine Bureau of Fire Protection says charges will be filed against those responsible for the Tandansora building fire. In a statement, the BFP says initial findings revealed that the parked vehicles in the three-story building may have blocked the escape routes. Stockpiled textile materials and some wooden constructions were also seen as contributing factors to the flames.
At the angulo ng rewiring activity a day before the incident occurred.
DNA samples will be collected from the victims' families to properly identify the remains. Philippine Catholic bishops agreed to cooperate on a limited basis with the government's anti-communist task force. A spokesperson for the Catholic Bishops' Conference says only their public affairs commission will work jointly with the national task force to end local communist armed conflict. This, as the task force has been repeatedly criticized for allegedly labeling the government's critics as communist collaborators.
We were invited to join. Nakita namin yung opportunity na makapagbigay din kami. Unang-una ng input namin coming from the church. Our advocacy is number one, to uphold human rights. Pangalawa, protection of human life. At ang pangatlo, gusto namin makapagbigay ng moral ethical solutions and directions to the problem of insurgency.
Meanwhile, the National Security Council welcomes the CBCP's move. It adds, the task force is open to suggestions from the church in adopting moral and ethical approaches in addressing communist insurgency. Heads up, motorists, oil prices are headed higher yet again. This will mark the 9th consecutive week of increases. Latest estimates show diesel prices could go up by as much as 1 peso and 10 centavos, while gasoline prices may see a 20 to 50 centavo markup. As for kerosene, prices may go up by at least 90 centavos. The Philippine Toll Regulatory Board two-month dry run for cashless transactions in tollways going well since it started Friday. According to its spokesperson Julius Corpus, there are no major issues so far with the dry run implementation. There was some buildup, though, in some participating plazas, which she attributed to the inclement weather and the volume of motorists. Corpus adds the expressways are still open for cash transactions during the dry run.
May direction or sign naman po na magbibigay sa kanila kung saan sila pupunta kung wala pa silang RFID. Doon po, pwede silang magbayad ng cash at hihikayatin silang maglagay o ilagyan na ng RFID o tuturuan sila kung saan sila pwedeng magpakadet ng RFID.
Some groups calling for the outright abolition of the revised guidelines for Filipinos deporting the country. Instead of imposing stricter rules, they argue that the Philippine government should focus on going after human traffickers instead. Mike Navallo reports.
If senators welcomed the Department of Justice and Anti-Trafficking Council's decision to suspend the implementation of the revised guidelines for Filipinos leaving the country.
Usigin sindikato!
For this group, the Philippine government should do away with any form of restriction for Filipinos who only wish to travel abroad.
Ang pagtingin nila lahat ng babiyahe sa ibang bansa ay posibleng human trafficking victim o kasangkot. No, unless patunayan natin na hindi tayo sangkot sa human trafficking. Napakahigpit, napaka-discriminatory, at napakalupit nito.
The groups expressed concern over the volume of documents that immigration officers might require, such as proof of financial capacity for self-funded tourists and overseas employment certificate for overseas Filipino workers or OFWs.
Bago pa po kami umalis at magplano na magtrabaho sa ibang bansa, baon na po kami sa utang sa pagpuproseso pa lang ng mga papel. Ngayon kung dadanasin po namin na ma-upload kami, anong mukha po ang iaharap namin sa pamilya naming iniwan namin sa probinsya?
They also questioned if the 2015 guidelines currently in place, which DOJ says is similar to the suspended guidelines, are even effective in the first place. In 2022, of the 32,000 Filipino passengers whose flights were deferred, less than 500 or only 1.46% were found to be victims of human trafficking. Even a Filipino trafficking survivor from Syria is opposed to the new travel guidelines, which are supposed to protect victims like her.
Marami po tayong mga under the table nga pong nangyayari. Diba? Sana po yun yung tinututukan ng taga-IACAT.
The DOJ and IACAT had earlier explained only a small portion of travelers will be affected by the revised guidelines.
All of these conclusions being made are speculative. Pero papaliwanag po natin na maayos. Nag-usap kami ni Commissioner Tancinco na ang training nila ay reminders talaga kung paano mag-handle ng situations where questions have to be asked.
The Bureau of Immigration explained the additional supporting documents would only be needed if the passenger fails to pass the primary inspection, which would only require the traveler's passport, boarding pass, return ticket, and visa.
What we're looking at, generally speaking po, triangulation po ng tatlong bagay. The documents they are presenting, their statements, and their demeanor.
The agency denied the guidelines will lead to discrimination.
Hindi po natin tinitingnan yung itsura or suot po ng passenger. Kahit nakachinelas po yan, it doesn't matter po for our immigration personnel.
Sandoval added, authorities are doing what they can to go after those behind human trafficking. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.
The boss of Moe Hennessy bullish about the Philippine market. CEO Philippe Shaus told ANC during his visit in the country, the brand wants to be a part of the development of the local tourism industry while bringing products that elevate the tourism experience.
First of all, why is Philippines important? I mean, it's a growing market. I mean, it's local consumption, a local market. I mean, we know, we anticipate that GDP in Philippines will grow about 5-6% per year over next year, which is a lot. So there will be a build-up, a development of the local wealth. But then, of course, Philippines is a wonderful tourist destination.